Welcome to Nursing Research Lecture. In today's class, we are going to discuss sampling process and factors influencing sampling process. In previous research lecture, we have seen what is population and what are the different terminologies related to population, sample, and sampling. So continue with that. Today we will see sampling process. Sampling is a process of selecting an observation to provide an adequate description and inference of the population. So from the population, that is from our observation, we are going to select a portion of population that is called as sample. So with this sample, we can give adequate description and we can interpret the result of our sample, we can generalize to the population criteria, population characteristic. So it is a process by which we select observation to get adequate description and inference of the population. So sample, basically it is a unit which is selected from the population, and sample represents a whole population. So the characteristics of population will be similar to the characteristics of sample, and purpose of the sample is to draw the inference, that is to our research, the result will give the inference meaning is the interpretation. For that only we are going to take the sample. From the sample, what values the sample gets, that we can able to compare that the sample value is like that. Similarly, the population also will be having the same type of characteristics and same type of values we can able to generalize. Next, we will see the steps in sampling process. Sampling process having the five steps. First one is define the target population. Second one is determine the sampling frame. Third one is selecting a sampling technique. Fourth one, determine the sample size. Fifth one, execute the sampling process. So these are the five steps in sampling process. Let us see one by one in detail. First one, we are going to define the target population. In previous video, we seen what is target population. The population from that which are having which meets our specially designated criteria will be the target population. The target population consists of total group of people or object which are meeting the designated set of criteria of the total group of population. I told the example, MSc nursing students in India as the population, and target population, MSc nursing students in India who can speak more than 4 languages. So that criteria, whoever meeting in the MSc nursing students are the target populations. Okay, the target population is the aggregate of cases, that is the number of cases which we take from the population who is meeting the designed criteria is called as target population. So our research finding that we are going to generalize over the target population only. Next, we will see the second step, that is defining the sampling frame. This also we have seen in the previous video in the terminologies. Sampling frame is the list of elements or list of subjects that we get from the target population. So it consists of, the sampling frame consists of the directions which tells who are all going to be included from the target population. The best example is the telephone directory. So in the telephone directory, we get information that who are all living in Panipat, what is their BSNL landline number. So like that, we can be able to select the sample from the sampling frame very easily. So it is a register, or you can say it is a list which having the details about all the subjects, particularly those who are coming from the target population. Other examples are the student's attendance register. So in that, we can have the student's name, father name, gender, everything. Like that, the antenatal attendance register in the clinic, maternity clinic. Whoever antenatal mother visiting the maternity clinic, their name will be enrolled in a register. So when you take that register, you get idea how many antenatal mothers are coming for checkup. So that mothers you can use for selecting the sample from that attendance register, otherwise that is called sampling frame. The next one is selecting a sampling technique. Once you have the sampling frame in your hand, very easy for us to select the sample by using the technique, a probability sampling technique, or by using non-probability sampling techniques. There are two types of techniques which we use in the research to recruit the sample. First one is probability, or otherwise it is called as random sampling method. So the second one is non-probability, or otherwise it is called as non-random sampling technique. So to select the sample, we need to consider some of the factors. The factors are, first one is type of population. When you know what population, what is your population, what is the characteristic of your population, then it is very easy for us to select the sample. So you must clearly define your target population, clearly define your population, then we can select the samples very easily. Next one is what type of phenomenon involved in your study. For example, when we use true experimental research design, then we need to go for probability sampling technique. So when you are using descriptive research, during that time we are going for non-probability sampling technique. When the sample size is going to be bigger, it is very easy to when the target population is having adequate numbers, then we can go for probability sampling technique. For example, in an area when we are not able to get adequate number of cases, that time randomization is not possible, then we will go for non-probability random sampling method. So that is a type of phenomenon under the study. Next one is available of resource and knowledge of the researcher. So as a researcher, when you have good knowledge, you know which type of technique will be very appropriate for the research. So simply selecting sample does not give good result. The result must be very precise, free from error. So that depends upon our sampling technique only. So when you're going to do a research in all over India, during that time we can go for like cluster sampling technique, or you can go for some other sampling techniques, like we can go for example, convenient sampling method, like that we can use. So that knowledge is very, very important. Apart from that, available of resources. When we have good transport facility, when we have good telecommunication facilities, then easy for us to select the sample, the desired number of sample easily we can select. So these are the three factors you need to keep in mind when you select sample. Now let's see the next step, that is determining the size of the sample. So we have every research have sample size based on the we use some calculation to determine how many number of sample is needed in our research. So when we use that formula, we get the exact number of sample which we need. So simply you cannot select the size of the sample for your study. So selecting the sample based on the desire, based on the size calculation, will help you to get the very valid and reliable findings. So sample size is determined priorly before selecting the samples. Okay, next one, sampling process execute. Once we have decided the target populations, once we have a good sampling frame, when we know what technique we want to use, when we have calculated the sample size, the next work for the researcher is to execute the sampling process. So when we implement the sampling process, we should not have any kind of problems. So if there is any problem in taking the sample, then we need to redefine the population. Again, we need to do all the steps, and then only we can able to select the sample. So mostly the samples are selected from the accessible population. You know the difference between target population and accessible population. Accessible population is the one to whom the researcher have easy contact, to those population where the researcher can easily communicate, easily can go and meet them. So that type of population is called accessible population. Okay, these accessible population are also the representative of the population only. So before collecting data, the sampling process has to be executed. So hope you understand the sampling process. Now let's see another important question. What are the factors influencing sampling process? Sampling process is influenced by three main factors. First one is nature of the researcher. Second one is nature of the sample. Third one is nature of the circumstances. These three factors mainly influencing the sampling process. The first one is nature of the researcher. Let's see the factors coming under nature of the researcher. First one is inexperienced investigator. Second, lack of interest. Third, lack of honesty. Fourth, intensive workload. And fifth, inadequate supervision. So let's discuss one by one in detail. First one is inexperienced investigator. So when you begin to do your research for the first time, your knowledge is very less and your experience is not adequate to do the research without the help of others. So during that time, you may not select the sample properly because of lack of knowledge and inexperience. So this may give errors in your finding. So that is the first one. So a person having good knowledge and more experience will follow good sampling process. Next one is lack of interest. Simply doing the research for just for getting some fund, or simply doing the research for paper certificate purpose or for the degree purpose. So that shows you are not doing the research with full motivation, and you are not getting the proper involvement in the research. So that will affect our sampling process, sampling selection. So in kitchen, when our mother is not cooking the food properly, the food won't be taste like that. When you don't have interest in the research, definitely you cannot do the sample selection properly. Lack of honesty. So every researcher must be honest in doing the research work. So any work which you do without honest, that will not be a successful one. Similarly, in the research, when you do the work in a honest way, that will give you a fruitful result. The fourth one is intensive workload. If you have more work in doing research, when you have large number of samples, when you have lot of variables in your research, during that time, excessive workload will affect the researcher in executing the proper sampling process. The researcher, when having lot of burden, cannot focus his attention in the sampling technique. That leads to error. The next one is inadequate supervision. If your guide is not giving adequate time to check your activities in the research, the researcher can commit lot of mistakes. So lack of supervision, inadequate supervision will leads to leads the researcher to have some mistakes in selecting the sample. So good supervision will help the researcher to recruit the sample properly. Next one is the nature of the sample. So three factors comes under nature of the sample. First one is inappropriate sampling technique. Next one, sample size. Third one is defective sampling frame. Let's see the first one, inappropriate sampling technique. For true experimental research design, when you go for non-probability random sampling technique, that gives you wrong inferences. So you must know which type of technique should be applied in your research. So inappropriate sampling technique leads to failure in the interpreting the result correctly. Next one is sample size. The excess number of sample in your study or very less number of sample in your study can also affect your study result. So with for example, when we have large number of sample, it is very difficult to get the homogeneous characteristic of the sample. So when the samples are heterogeneous, definitely the research result will not have that much accurate. The research result will not be able to generalize with the population. So this is, for example, when you do a research, you need nursing students. In the sample, you don't have some nursing students. So you are putting physiotherapy students, means that is contamination of the sample. So this is about sample size, how it affects our sampling technique. Similarly, very less number of sample in the study also does not give the precise findings. The finding cannot be reliable and it cannot be valid. The next characteristic is defective sampling frame. So if you are not having a good knowledge about the population, when you don't have good cooperation with the population, you cannot make a good sampling frame. So inadequate sampling frame, inadequate information about the sample will not help the researcher to collect the data properly, and as a result of this, the study findings is going to be affected. So this is about defective sampling frame. Next one is circumstances. So there are four factors comes under circumstances. First one is lack of time. Next one is large geographic area. Third one is lack of cooperation. Fourth one is natural calamities. The first one is lack of time. You must plan the sampling process perfectly. You must take good time to decide which technique you are going to implement in selecting the sample. So very rapidly, in a hurry-burry way, when you select the technique for recruiting the sample, that may be flaw. That may lead to sampling bias. Next one is large geographic area. When you are going to do the research in a vast area, in the geographical wise, definitely you cannot go for some other methods like simple random sampling. So when you have multi-stage sampling method, you can go for simple random. Simply you cannot go for simple random. So for example, during that time you can go for cluster sampling technique. Now let's see the third one, lack of cooperation. When you don't have good relationship with your population, when the population does not give adequate information to you, then you cannot make a sampling frame. Without having adequate cooperation with your guide, that also may affect your sample selection process. So then automatically the result cannot be good as you expect. The last one in this is natural calamities. During the time of doing research, anything can happen in the nature. For example, at present, coronavirus came, so there is lockdown. Sometimes flood may come. You cannot go to that area because of the water stagnation. Sometimes there may be earthquake or some other problems may occur in the world. So all these things may affect the researchers' effort to get a good sample. So this is about natural calamities. So these are the various factors which affects the sampling process. So hope you understand the sampling process and the factors affecting sampling process, sampling selection. So in exam point of view, they may ask question like sampling process, or they can ask you to write the factors affecting sampling techniques or sampling process. So in next video, we will see what are the techniques used in selecting sample. So read this topic carefully so that you can able to attend the questions very correctly in the exam. Thank you. Take care. Bye-bye.